Hey guys, it's Hafedet here, with a slightly different format than usual. Ever since the first episode, my videos have been mostly theoretical. And while theory is an important foundation, oftentimes many things may come across as fun facts that are pointless to know. This is what I want to address with the applied videos, by showing how some of the theory applies to real situations and what advantages you can gain from that. If you haven't done so already, episodes 4, 6 and 8 are suggested watching either now or afterwards to fully understand everything. Alright, so how do we use our knowledge of hitboxes and hit physics to figure out which car is the best at dribbling and even by how much it is the best? For this, I'd like to divide dribbling up into different aspects. Cars can be evaluated objectively for each of these. Which car is the best overall would then depend on how important you consider each of the categories. For the exact stats, please look at my car stats spreadsheet, which is linked in the video description. First up, tightest possible turn. Now, I'm not talking about the turning radius of the car here, but the tightest possible circle that you can make the ball go in. Well, how do we make the ball go in a circle? As you may have learned in a physics class, to make the ball go in a circle, we need to apply centripetal force. That means we constantly need a force pushing the ball perpendicular to its current velocity. To do this, we have to place the ball either exactly left or exactly right of the center of mass, depending on which way we want to turn. The size of the turning circle depends on the forward speed of the ball and the amount of centripetal force we are applying. The higher the forward speed, the bigger the turning circle. But the more centripetal force we apply, the tighter the circle gets. So our goal is to get the most centripetal force possible. And this is where we have to take into account the weird Rocket League physics. The basic hit vector goes from the center of mass of the car to the center of the ball. In a best case scenario, we would place them both at the same height. But since the ball would have to go below the ground, it's not really possible. Instead, we place the ball as low as we can and as far away from the center of mass as we can. That means the horizontal force gets maximized. Depending on the geometry of the car, the placement of the ball differs and the presets also have their center of mass at different heights. So even though all the cars will act the same amount of force, they will act at a different angle and we want that angle to be as low as possible. I've done the math and, well, the difference between the best and the worst preset is only 1%. Details are in the car stats spreadsheet. However, when we need a lot of centripetal force, the hit physics will make us apply more vertical force too. There comes a point where it becomes stronger than gravity and the ball wanders up on your roof. And here's the culprit. On the roof, at even the furthest point to the side, the force is less than 40% of the maximum possible force. The roof also has another problem. If the ball starts to bounce, then the car won't interact with it at all. Ergo, no force. Therefore, if you're trying to turn tight, you always need to have the lowest point of the ball below the roof, because then it will be guaranteed to get hit when you turn into it. If your car is taller, then you will have more vertical room to play with. This is the real reason for why cars with tall hitboxes are great for dribbling. To sum it up, in theory, you could do essentially just as tight of a turn with every single preset, but in practice, you will probably do it better with a tall car. Next aspect. Precision adjustments. This is the polar opposite of the tightest possible turn. If you want to have a slight effect on the ball, you want to place it on the roof and close to the center of mass. But how do presets differ? For that, I calculated the direction of the force when you place it exactly 40 unreal units off to the side. Because of their height, Hybrid and Octane will act less force to the sides. The same is true for accelerating and decelerating the ball. It might seem bad to have less force, but as a human, it's likely better to have small movements affect the ball in small amounts, because it's easier to be precise. We are only looking at a 9% increase in sensitivity for the Planck / Bettenbye presets, but it's definitely something that could be noticed. The rest of the numbers are in the spreadsheet. Aspect number 3. Catching the ball out of the air. Usually, when we do this, we don't want the ball to bounce. We want to just catch and keep going. Minimize the force upwards. Meaning, let it bounce far away from the center of mass. Of course, there is a limit to how far, because otherwise you won't be able to catch up with the ball and it will just drop to the ground. The car doesn't really matter, as long as you're used to it. Only if the ball is traveling towards you will you want the maximum amount of force. In that case, long presets like the breakout perform the best. Aspect 4. Bounce dribbles. To keep a bounce dribble going, you need to dive into the ball at just the right time after it's landed. Naturally, the timing window to hit the ball without a jump is bigger with taller presets. The octane at the front is about 25% higher than the breakout, giving you over 25% more time to hit the ball. Last aspect, flicks. Unfortunately, these will require lots more research by me, and they are very own video. So take the following with a grain of salt, as it's not very scientific. I have noticed, like many others, that long cars can flick the ball faster and higher. Whether that is because they end up getting more touches or something else, I don't know yet, so this is not a final statement. But it is something important to keep in mind for the whole picture. Alright, I hope that this showed why the Octane is objectively great at dribbling, but not necessarily superior in every way. If you get used to a different preset, you can still do tight cuts and turns. Big thanks to all my patrons for the financial support. If you want to back me too, you can do so at the link on screen. In return, you get to vote on topic priority. Now go follow me on Twitter at halfwaydeadrl and I'll see you soon for the next video.